Hello everyone and welcome to this video. So today I am in York for the Hamster Fair. And yeah, I'm gonna vlog it. So let's go. I've just gotta show you what I'm wearing one second. So I got my channel logo embroidered on this by Lucy and Lola. I think it's the Lucy and Lola shop. I found them on TikTok. And yeah, I've got a few other things that I'm wearing, which is from them. So let me show you. So first of all, we have this cap, which has Jasper on it. Jasper actually hasn't been introduced on this YouTube channel, but he has been introduced on Instagram and TikTok, the two other socials that I have. So if you don't follow me on there, this is what Jasper looks like, and he's a Syrian hamster. And it's actually not that warm today, so I'm bringing this jumper with me, which has Skittle and Gumdrop on it. I got Skittle before I started this channel, so you probably won't have seen anything of it, maybe a few clips I've shared. But yes, I'm going to be wearing this, and I absolutely love the colour. And I also bought a couple other things from the Lucy and Lola shop as well. So yes, so I have a bunch of other stuff with all of my other pets on it, but these are just the ones that I decided to bring today because these are all four hamsters that I've owned. Yeah, this is Cookie Dough, who is the one on my YouTube logo. So I just put this jumper on because we are about to go, so let's go. And you can probably tell that I'm not a morning person at all. So just a slight bump in the road. We can't find our car. It's not where we parked it, and we followed like a Google Maps thing saying where it is, and it's led us to this private parking place, which we have never been to before. So that is fantastic. Okay everyone, so we are finally in the car an hour and a half later. So here's a little story time. Like what happened. So we went to this one car park, which was the car park that we thought we parked at because the hotel said that they have like a partnership with it and that's where they like recommend people to park. So we went there, it was like a 10 minute walk, it was fine. And then we spent like 20 minutes looking for our car there, was not there. We checked every single floor several times, car was not there. So we were like, okay, has it been towed away? Because like we paid for it and everything.
This is police.
Oh, okay, police is calling now. Okay, so yeah, the car was not there, so we're like, okay, has it been towed away? Like we paid for it, you're allowed to park overnight, everything, like why would they need to tow it? So I'm like, okay, has it been stolen then? So then my mom went on her phone, because her phone, like I don't really know how it works because I don't have a car, but her phone like knows where the car is, so then like it can track it. So then it said the car was like, what was it, like 10 minutes away, 10 minutes away somewhere completely different. So then we were like, okay, and then we were like, so then we decided just to go to where the car supposedly was. So yeah, we walked over to there.
You know
where it took us?
Private car parks.
It took us to a private car park with like...
Well, not a car park, it was like a residential with,
yeah.
With garages.
Yeah, with residential people where they park their cars in garages. So there were like 20 or so garages there where people park their cars. We were like, okay.
It must have been stolen.
Yeah, it must have been stolen. Yeah, so we thought it was stolen. We were freaking out. We called the police, but the police had a bunch of like more important stuff to do, so they said that they would call us back, which is why they just called us. Yes, yeah, so we were freaking out. Like it was stolen. What do we do now? So yeah, we called the police, but then we called the hotel back and we said, okay, our car's not there. And then what was it they said? They said that there's another hotel.
Well,
another
said,
car park.
Our car wasn't at the car park that you have a partnership with. And the guy said, yeah, at the car park. I was like, no, that's not the one that I was just, you know, that you have a partnership with.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, let's go and check this car park before we speak to the police again.
Yeah. So we went to car park.
And lo and behold,
the car was there.
Victor, we're now in the car.
After tons of walking and freaking out, we are now in the car and on our way. So we've missed like the first two talks, unfortunately, which was the introduction talk by Happy Hamsters UK and the hamster welfare talk. We might make it for like the last 20 minutes of the hamster welfare talk, hopefully.
But on a good note, we do have a funny story to tell.
Yes, we have a funny story to tell.
Life is never so bad, life is not good for something.
Yes. We were on the call with my sister and my grandma, because my grandma's looking after my sister.
My grandma, well, your grandma was freaking out.
Yes, they were both freaking out.
Don't intervene with the, you know, the thief. Don't try and take him on.
Yeah.
Call the police, keep safe.
And there was this guy who was like standing across from us. He was just standing there. So I was like while we were in the private car park, and I thought that was kind of scary. But it's all good now, and we're on the way there. I need to get the tickets ready, but I will see you guys when we're in there. We are back in the car now. I've been to most of the stalls. I've had loads of good talks with a lot of the stall owners and a bunch of people about hamsters, which we all share the same interest, hamsters. And it's been really amazing, and I bought a ton of stuff. But we are going to take a quick lunch break now. We're going to go to find the closest food place just to grab some food and some water, because I stupidly did not bring any water, and as you can see I am very hot now, so very red. So yeah, we're going to go get some water and then we're going to go back, listen to some of the talks and take a look at the rest of the stalls, and yeah. Listened to the Q&A and the talk from an exotic vet, which was really interesting. Both of them were really interesting. I learned a lot, and that was awesome. And then I visited a few of the stores that I didn't get a chance to visit before, and I had an amazing time. And thank you so much to everyone who organized it. I had an amazing time. Bye everyone, I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I'll be doing a haul of everything I got very soon.